What's up, all my Nickapediacs? Okay, today we have a special guest joining us, Diana Cowern. You may know her from Physics Girl.
That's where I usually am.
That's the planet Physics Girl. It's actually her YouTube channel. It's super awesome. But it's kind of like, you know, it's kind of like her superhero name, you know? Mine's Dr. Super Weird, or Dr. Dad, because I love puns so much. I'm a pretty punny guy.
Dr. Dad is the weirdest superhero name I think I've ever.
Yeah, he comes in on a 6-speed minivan and he ruins your day. Speaking of dads, did you ever leave the front door open in the summer as a kid and your dad told you something like this? We're not air conditioning the whole neighborhood. You know, and he probably said it all super dad-like, you know, and threw up his hands in the air slightly and then focused really intently on telling your mother, wow, we're not going to your grandparents' house for Christmas. It's just not a good idea. Maybe that was just my house, I don't know.
I think that was just your family.
Oh, well.
I'm sorry.
Well, if this has ever happened to you, today we're going to set the record straight and do a little experiment, and we're gonna see exactly how fast the AC is just rushing out the front of your house. And this can be applied actually to other things too, like your house or in a room or anything like that.
Yeah, we're also gonna test how fast cold air leaves your car and your fridge, because you don't wanna refrigerate the whole living room now, do ya?
No.
Because that's not how physics works.
Okay, but how would we do something like that?
Well, we would need a special camera, like one that sees in temperature.
What?
And that's exactly what I have brought here today.
Yes!
For Nick.
That looks like a phone.
This is the camera, Nick. Oh, God. We have a FLIR camera that sees in thermal infrared.
Oh.
Yeah, it's right here.
And then it plugs into the phone.
It plugs into the phone.
And you can see it on the other side.
And then on the other side, you can see infrared.
So before we get started on this experiment, let's talk really quickly about what infrared is and how these cameras work.
Infrared light is a type of radiation that's between the visible and the microwave portion of the electromagnetic spectrum. This means that infrared wavelengths are longer than visible light, but shorter than microwaves.
Oh, so like sandwiched kind of like right in between them.
Right in the middle.
So it's like we can't see them because they're outside of the visible spectrum.
Yes.
But they're not quite like as far down as like the microwave.
Yeah, they're not, the wavelength isn't as long as microwaves, so they're not used for microwave purposes.
Gotcha, okay. Yeah. So we're not gonna be seeing any microwaves.
No. All right. Well, you can't see microwaves either.
Or can you? I've got a microwave. I see it every morning.
Oh, okay. Yeah. Dr. Dad strikes again.
Kill him the game here. Okay, one of the things infrared is used for is to measure the heat radiated by different objects. Now, whether you think so or not, all objects, even the ones you think of as cold, like ice cubes, produce infrared radiation.
Yeah, cold things. Huh. They emit infrared.
How cool is that?
No, there it goes again. This is the type of radiation that's given off by the motion of atoms and molecules in an object. And all objects have atoms that are moving inside of them, unless they're at absolute zero, which is the state of no atoms moving, which occurs at -459.67 Fahrenheit.
That's really cold.
It's super cold.
That's
it is the
cold.
Coldest. Oh. Any object that has motion of atoms will have a temperature above absolute zero and therefore will be emitting at least some infrared radiation, which is all objects because you can't actually get to absolute zero.
Some objects are super hot and we can see that they're super hot. You know, like the lava that took out Anakin Skywalker's, well, his hair, and then he turned into Darth Vader. Well, he turned into Darth Vader later, but you know what I mean? Like, God, what a rough day for this poor guy, you know? He lost his legs, his best friend, and then he was gonna have a kid, and then he, oh gosh, just a tragedy story. Anyways, other objects are very hot, like, you know, your oven top, like the ones that your parents told you not to touch, but went ahead and touched anyways, and you know, you got that super big blister.
I totally never did that, and that's not at all what this scar is from.
You even have a scar.
Look at it.
You were that person.
I was that person.
You were like, it doesn't look hot, and they're like, don't touch it, it's hot, and you were like,
no, I was like, I know it's hot, but it doesn't look hot anymore because I had used it before. If I had had an infrared camera.
Boom.
To see the leftover hotness.
Yes. These types of objects are hot, but not hot enough to emit visible light. This is where an infrared detecting device can come in handy, and that's exactly what infrared cameras do.
Infrared cameras work by detecting all of that infrared energy being emitted by objects and converting it into an electronic signal.
This signal is then processed to make a thermal image, which looks exactly like the image that the predator uses to track down Arnold in the jungle, and then again take out the aliens. But seriously, how disappointing was Alien versus Predator?
Disappointing I never saw it.
Okay, let's get to the chopper and start using our FLIR infrared camera to see how long we have until we've air conditioned the entire neighborhood. You ready?
Let's do it.
Okay, so here's what we're gonna do. We have three things we wanna test.
Okay.
We wanna see how long it takes for all the AC to leave a doorway, basically. Like, if we're air conditioning a room, we wanna see how long that's gonna take. Now, one of the issues is that the FLIR doesn't really pick up air very well, right? So we have to have like an object inside of the room and then test how long that object turns color so that we know that that object is now warmer or colder, right?
So you've got something cooling, you've got a room cooling down, there's stuff in there that's cooling down with the air, and then we're gonna see how fast those objects, you know, come back to room temperature, right?
Yeah, and what I wanted to use is, I wanted to use an apple. Now, I know we're not an apple, right? But apple's mostly water, mostly water, assuming as such that like the apple was a good indicator of like how quickly something would change temperature, right?
Right.
So that'll
right.
tell us how long we have until the AC is just totally gone from the room, or how long it would be until we're just basically like uncomfortable, right?
Yeah.
So that's what we're gonna do. Then we're also gonna test the refrigerator and see maybe like what happens if you left the refrigerator open. And we're gonna do the same thing in the car to see how long it takes with the car doors open to see what the internal temperature of things and like where essentially things are turning a different color to indicate like how long you can keep the door open before it just becomes uncomfortable.
Mm-hmm.
So what we're gonna do right now is we're filming the refrigerator. So we're getting 39 degrees in there.
Yeah, so right now you're aiming at like the back of the fridge, and so you're probably still, you're getting stuff that's been cooling down for a while.
We're at a minute now, right? Now let's say like you left your refrigerator open for a minute and your parents are already yelling at you, you know, we're not trying to refrigerate the whole house. So as you can see inside the fridge, things really haven't changed much.
So that's the thing, that's one of the things about this myth of letting all the cold air out. Yes, you may be replacing all the cold air inside the fridge with warm air from the room, but you've got all these other things that have a higher heat capacity, meaning like you need a lot more heat to warm them up, and those aren't gonna lose heat very fast.
Okay, so conclusion, leaving the fridge open is not gonna refrigerate your whole house, and it's not gonna spoil everything inside.
That being said, you should probably close the refrigerator some point.
You don't want to waste the energy, you know? That's just, you don't want to do that. Okay. All right. So we turned this AC on about maybe like 10 minutes ago, right? And so we're going to go investigate and see what happens. So we're going to go ahead and open the door and see what our apple, how much our the temperature of our apple changes. All right, I can feel that it's really cold. And if you look down there, you can see the apple is actually pretty chilly, okay? Okay, so now the door has been open for at least a minute. And our apple's getting colder, 62.1. We've now gone over 3 minutes. The room is relatively, everything in the room is maintaining the temperature. And that's because what we talked about earlier, it's the same thing as with the refrigerator. All the objects in the room are so cold still that it's maintaining this sort of like cold feeling of the room. And if I were to shut the door, then the air temperature would get cold really quickly, because all the objects are solids and the specific heat capacity of those is really high. It's not really myth busted, right? Because when you open the door, the air does come out. But what all the dads are forgetting across the universe is that all the objects in your house, and if you've been running the AC all summer long, all those objects are really cold. And it's gonna keep your house really cold, and so you're not gonna air condition the entire neighborhood. All right, there's my car over there. And as you can see from the side angle here, the windows are very cool. They're very, very cool. That's the AC at work there. I'm sure if I go over there and touch them, they're gonna be very cold. You can see that the engine, that's obviously very hot. That's where the internal combustion engine is. It's burning gasoline. I'm really interested to see what happens when I open the door. So let's go take a look. That's really neat. That's really cool. Car is open. It's pretty warm inside. You can see like where the vents are right here. This is the AC. It's really warm around this area and then my seats. So we're gonna just go ahead and like, you know, keep this, so we're at 75.2, okay? And we're at a minute. So we're gonna go ahead and just keep it on the seats since that's where I'm gonna be sitting. All right, we're at 4 minutes and we're gonna go ahead and test the seat again.
seat is reading at 78.6 on the side that the door is open on. On the side that the door is not open on, 75.2. So we got the temperature rose about 3 degrees total from keeping the door open the entire time. Again, this gets back to this point that when you're cooling things on the inside, the objects that are solid are becoming a lot cooler, and that's also then going to cool the air because those objects are gonna take a lot longer to cool than the air itself. All right, so what did we learn today?
Well, we learned a lot. We learned so much. We learned that when you open something up, you're not letting out all the air.
You're just not. It's totally busted.
Well, okay.
Kind of.
You're letting out a lot of the air, but that doesn't really affect the temperature of everything in the room, everything in the fridge.
Right. It may get warmer. The air temperature might, because air is really easy to heat and cool.
Exactly.
But the other objects that are more solid in the room, especially if they have water, mm-hmm. are very difficult because the specific heat capacity of water is so high mm-hmm. that what you're not accounting for is that the room is already cold. The objects in the room itself is already cold.
Yeah, exactly. So like, even if you let out all the cold air, it would be really easy to cool down that air. It's all the objects inside that took a while to cool down and are gonna take a while to heat back up. So it doesn't really matter that you've let out the cold air.
So take that, dads across the world. We're gonna heat nothing. Or something. Okay. Where can we find you? So we did this whole video on your channel, right? What's your channel called?
My channel is called Physics Girl, and we talked a lot about infrared radiation. We talked about what you can do, like mysteries that you can solve.
Mysteries you can solve
using
with infrared camera.
Yeah.
So that video, we shot that at YouTube Space LA, and here you're gonna see that video in about like 10 seconds. So make sure to click that video, subscribe to her channel if you haven't already. Awesome physics stuff. It's super cool. I love your channel, by the way.
Thank you.
Thank you
Likewise.
So much for coming on.
So much mutual love.
Thank you. So much.
Thank you.
Nailed it. Myth busted. Shkaboom. That's all I got.